Did you know that real wasabi can cost as much as $250 a kilogram? That's right. There's a thing called real wasabi, and you've probably never had it before. Then again, I don't know your life. What you normally have in your sushi box is this $2 green paste. Why is real wasabi so expensive? Is it that much better than the fake stuff used in restaurants? We'll compare the two items and decide if the $250 price tag is worth it over the $2 option. First, let's talk about how these two items are made. The cheap wasabi is often made with mustard flour, cornstarch, soy sauce, anchovies, and the key ingredient, horseradish, with green food coloring. Horseradish root is from the same family as wasabi. This is what gives you that signature kick when put on your California roll. Making real wasabi, on the other hand, is way more meticulous and time-consuming. To even start, real wasabi comes from a plant you have to grow. They're grown in a dedicated wasabi farm that costs around $700,000 per acre. And in order for these plants to survive, the conditions need to be perfect. They grow in shaded mountain streams as they need to avoid direct sunlight. Wasabi plants also need to be submerged in cold water. And if the soil conditions aren't just right, wasabi farmers will be met with a dead plant. After 6 to 8 weeks, the outer leaves of the wasabi can be harvested. But the edible wasabi is made by grinding up the stem. And the stem takes 2 years before it can be harvested. After waiting just a casual 2 years for the stems, you can then grate them. That's real wasabi for you. It's traditionally not made into a paste, but comes straight off the plant and onto your plate. Now that we know how they're made, how does expensive wasabi taste different from the cheaper alternative? Fresh wasabi is even spicier than the horseradish substitute. The initial kick clears out your sinuses, then leaves a plant-like aftertaste. There's also a little bit of sweetness to it, which is a great pairing to the salty sushi. The grated plant has a sweet veggie flavor that lingers on after the spicy bang, while fake wasabi hits you with heat and quickly leaves, like a thief in the night. Here's a bonus fact. Wasabi has been grown in Japan for over 4 centuries and was first used to combat food illnesses. It would be topped on raw meat to decrease the risk of food poisoning. Wasabi has antimicrobial properties which help reduce the spread of diseases. This superfood can help relieve inflammation, fight cell damage, and improve your respiratory health. Horseradish offers similar benefits but is not as potent. The process it takes to grow the real deal explains the crazy cost. So the horseradish disguised as wasabi was originally made to cut the price down on sushi in Japan. Sushi was seen as a higher class dish, and using horseradish made it more accessible for everyone else. This was before sushi took off in popularity within North America. Now you can buy California rolls from your local grocery store. The time, money, and energy it takes to get fresh wasabi justifies the cost. But unless you're a wealthy food connoisseur, it doesn't seem like spending an extra $250 on wasabi will make the sushi taste that much better. Dyed horseradish tastes on par, and you can spend more money on better things, like more sushi. So real wasabi might not be worth it, but is a $300 steak worth the hefty price tag? They always say you get what you paid for, but those aren't always words to live by. See you next time on Price Wars.